Lenovo ThinkPad E495 is an entry-level business laptop, and in this video we will unbox and review AMD version of this device, which comes with Ryzen 5 3500U processor with integrated Vega 8 graphics. Content of the box is very simple: laptop, power adapter and short setup guide. Lenovo 65W power adapter with USB-C connector comes with almost 3 meters long cables, which is in most cases enough to avoid use of power extension cords when it is necessary to use full power of laptop or when it is time for battery recharge. Device looks well and quality built, and plastic outside and inside device feels good untouched, although some might argue that it looks cheap on first glance. Keyboard keys are not backlit and they are a little bit soft, but they are still offering nice response and together with their shape and height offer nice and enjoyable typing experience. MicroSD card slot, USB 2.0 connector, Ethernet port and security lock slot can be found on the right side of the laptop. On the left side, USB-C connector, HDMI, two USB 3.1 connectors and audio port are available. Standard 720p web camera offers mediocre quality and internal microphone comparing to similar laptops has a solid sound quality. Here is the sample of it.
This is the test of the microphone on ThinkPad E495.
Touchpad is very responsive and precise, but the plasticky feeling might not be pleasing for everybody. A 14-inch Full HD non-glossy IPS screen offers nice colors and contrast, although it feels like brightness could be better in some scenarios, especially if you're working outside during sunny weather. Sample video shows playback of the 4K video. As you can see, 4K videos are easily handled by this laptop without buffering or stuttering. Viewing angles on this screen are great, and it is possible to see clear image even under a 170 degree angle. This is great in some scenarios, but also indicator to be careful on airports or in the planes and implement some privacy protection when needed. For the performance tests, I use 3 performance tools and 2 other computers as a reference. Note the 2 other computers are a few years dated, but those are the configurations I had available and will help to get a sense of E495 performance. Computer configurations being compared are Lenovo ThinkPad E495 with AMD Ryzen 5 3500U CPU, Radeon Vega 8 graphic chip, 8GB of DDR4 RAM and Samsung M2 SSD with 256GB capacity. PC with Intel i7-4790K CPU, MSI GeForce GTX 970, 20GB of DDR3 RAM and crucial MX500 SSD with 512GB of storage space. HP EliteBook 840 G2 with Intel i5-5300U CPU, Intel HD Graphics 5500, 16GB of DDR3 RAM and SSD with 256GB of storage space. These 3 configurations will be tested in benchmark software Passmark, NovaBench and DiskMark, and results will be presented at the same time in order to easier understand how powerful is ThinkPad E495 in different areas when it comes to the CPU, GPU and disk performance comparing to other configurations. Passmark benchmark shows the results, which will be observed in other benchmark software as well. ThinkPad E495 AMD Ryzen 5 processor is very good and has slightly lower score than i7-4790K, and it is much better than i5-5300U on HP laptop. Graphics performance of the Radeon Vega 8 is pretty poor and cannot be compared with Nvidia GTX 970, but it is better than Intel 5500 graphics. We will show later in video realistic test and what can be expected in games. Single slot of slower 8GB DDR4 RAM results in weak memory performance and score for ThinkPad E495. For more demanding users, memory upgrade is definitely recommended in order to have dual channel and at least 16GB of RAM. But for pure office users, even this slower amount of slower RAM will be more than enough for all office tasks. Where ThinkPad E495 really shines is disk performance. If you have configured ThinkPad build with SSD drive, very fast Samsung M2 will be built in. This disk has 3500 MB per second sequential reading and 2200 MB per second sequential writing, which is observed in all tests as well. NovaBench scores show the same pattern as Passmark scores. CPU performance of Ryzen 5 is slightly worse than i7, but much better than i5. Memory is pretty slow and at the level of DDR3. Graphics is also very weak, especially 3D graphics, but disk performance is amazing and significantly better than standard SSD disk from PC and laptop. More detailed DiskMark test shows just how much faster is M2 in ThinkPad E495 comparing to SSD drives in PC and HP laptop. Sequential reading and writing is 4 to 6 times faster, but also random reading and writing is faster as well. When it comes to the gaming, we already observed from benchmark tests that Radeon Vega 8 graphic chip from ThinkPad E495 is not a 3D champion. Tests done in Counter-Strike Global Offensive and Rocket League show that in order to get 60 frames per second, which I consider a minimum playable FPS on PC for online competitive games, it is necessary to set all graphic settings to minimum. It is possible to get higher FPS as well, but in order to get that, game resolution needs to be reduced to lower resolution than native Full HD resolution, which makes the game look less visually appealing. During the usage of this laptop in past months, we observed an issue which cannot be observed in simple performance tests. Realtek Wi-Fi card in this laptop would sometimes disconnect and it was necessary to manually establish Wi-Fi connection. After a lot of trial and error, we found a version of the driver where disconnections are not observed anymore. But still there will be a random network speed slowdown which would disappear after manual disconnect and reconnect to the Wi-Fi network. Additional issue which we have observed is that sound from the laptop speakers is very loud, but sound quality is not good. Definitely not recommended to listen to the music on 100% sound volume. Positive impressions regarding this laptop are that CPU is very fast and battery and disk performance is good as advertised, and keyboard is pleasant for usage for a long time. That was the review of the ThinkPad E495 with all observed positive and negative angles. We use it for almost a year, and besides occasional annoying Wi-Fi problem, which we can see online that some other users have experienced as well, this laptop is exactly what we have expected. Solid office laptop with a strong processor for a decent price.